question. Is there any point in reporting zeta potential if we don't know the true equation to use? Is it okay to just report electrophoretic mobility? Firstly, the instrument measures electrophoretic mobility, and anything else it reports, zeta potential, is derived from it. So you aren't going to lose anything by doing so, and it is more appropriate to use it as raw data than zeta potential because of all the problems I've described about calculating zeta potential from the mobility. I can't recall a single instance of when I needed an absolute value for zeta potential except for checking against a standard. Just about everything I've done has been relative to something, a specification limit, an initial time point, and so on. And if I'm normalizing the data against something or comparing limits generated with the same method, then it's unnecessary to calculate zeta. Just stick with electrophoretic mobility. You'll reach the same conclusions and avoid having to contend with all the assumptions and caveats this webinar has been concerned with. I haven't discussed nonpolar dispersions at all, which was the primary purpose for developing POWs, but the concept of zeta potential in nonpolar media is questionable at least. Given one or two elemental charges, how can you define a double layer? What or where is zeta? So quite honestly, most of the time, I stick with mobility.